Good morning, dear students. In our previous video, we have learned some rules regarding direct and indirect speech. We have seen the definition of direct and indirect speech. We have seen how the tenses change from direct to indirect speech. Already you know that present tense changes to its corresponding past tense. Then simple past changes to past perfect. Past continuous changes to past perfect continuous. Let us see examples of some verbs, how they change from direct to indirect speech. Now all these changes take place only when the reporting verb is in past tense, as I told you in previous video, right? So when the reporting verb is in past tense, then all these tenses change. Okay, so if the verb is, are, or am, it changes to was or were. That is, are, am is present, it changes to past, that is was and were. Was and were, past, changes to perfect, past perfect, that is had been. Had been, past perfect, it doesn't change. Has or have, that is present perfect, will change to past, that is had. Had, there will be no change. Do, that is simple present, it will change to simple past. Did, did simple past will change to past perfect. Had done, had done past perfect, there will be no change. Then the verbs like will change to would, shall changes to should, can changes to could, may changes to might, must changes to had to. And the words like would, should, might, ought to, could, they do not change from direct to indirect speech. Okay, so this table also you have to note down in your notebook. Now let us see some examples how to change direct speech into indirect speech. He said, Roshni loves me. Now the reporting verb said is in past. So here the tense of the verb will change. Now which is the verb? Loves. It is in simple present. It will change to simple past. So he said that. Now we have to remove the inverted commas and put that. He said that Roshni loved him. He said that Roshni loved him. Next example. Mohit said, Pinky is writing a letter. Now is writing, it is in present continuous tense, it will change to past continuous tense. Mohit said that Pinky is will change to was. Was writing a letter. Next. Tom said, Ram has done his work. Has done. This is present perfect. It will change to past perfect. That is, has will change to had. Tom said that Ram had done his work. Next example. He said, I drank milk. Now drank. Drank is past tense. So it will change to past perfect. He said that he had drunk milk. So had drunk. This is past perfect tense. Has will change to had. Next example. Peter said Radha was dancing. Now the verb is was dancing. It is past continuous. So past continuous will change into past perfect continuous. That is, was will change into had been. Okay. Peter said that Radha had been dancing. Next, he said Priyanka shall come. So verb is shall. Shall will change to should. He said that Priyanka should come. Next example, the teacher said she will not pass. So the verb is will. Will will change to would. The teacher said that she would not pass. So I hope you have understood the changes from direct to indirect. Now see here, Roshan loves me. So loves is in simple present. It will change to simple past. That is loved. Then Pinky is writing. Present continuous will change to past continuous was writing. Has done. Present perfect will change to past perfect had done. If there is past perfect, then it will not change. It will remain as it is. Next, drank. Frank is simple past. It will change to past perfect. Had drunk. And was dancing. This is past continuous. It will change to past perfect continuous. Had been dancing. Then shall changes to should. Will changes to would. Okay. Some more examples. He said, Meenu may come. So may changes to might. He said that Meenu might come. He said Sujata can run fast. So can changes to could. He said that Sujata could run fast. Okay. Now when we are talking about any universal truth or habitual action, then the tense of the verb in indirect speech will not change. It will remain as it is. When we are talking about universal truth or habitual actions, the tense of the verb will not change in indirect speech. Let us see some examples. He said, man is mortal. Now, man is mortal. This is universal truth. So, the tense will not change. Now it is present, it will remain present only. It will not change in indirect speech. So he said that man is mortal. Next example. The teacher said the sun rises in the east. Universal truth. So the tense will not change. Rises is in present. It will remain in present only. The teacher said that the sun rises in the east. Okay. Now, there is also another rule. If there are two clauses, both in the past, then also the tense of the verb will not change. For example, Reena said to me, Neha was tired, so she did not go out to play with friends. See your children. Neha was tired. This is one clause.
and she did not want to go out to play with friends.
This is another clause,
and both the clauses are in past tense.
Both the clauses are in past tense, simple past. So what we have learned, that simple past changes to past perfect. But here there are two clauses and both the clauses are in simple past, so there will be no change in the tense.
So Reena said that, sorry, Reena told me that Neha was tired, so she did not go out to play with friends. Okay,
now first is the tense. Even though if the reporting verb is in past tense, the tense of the verb will not change in indirect speech when we talk about universal truth or habitual actions. Also, it doesn't change when there are two clauses both in past tense. Okay, then the third is when a situation is described which is still going on at the time of reporting. At that time also the tense of the verb will not change in indirect speech. For example, Mr. Gupta said all the flights writing. So the tense of this verb will not change, it will remain as it is. So Mr. Gupta said that the flights are delayed due to heavy rains. Sorry, all the flights are delayed due to heavy rains. So the tense remains the same. Okay. So in this situations, the tense doesn't change, it remains the same. Okay, so I hope you have understood the changes in tenses. Now let us talk about say and tell. We always say something, but tell somebody. We always say something, but tell somebody. Now you can see the example. He said man is mortal. So he said, is it referring to somebody? Is he telling to somebody? No, he just said. Okay, so we have used here said that. Okay, but see this example. Reena said to me, so tell somebody. So when we use said to, at that time said to changes to told. said to changes to told. So this you have to keep in mind. Don't write told to. Said to changes to told and not told to. Okay? So keep this in mind. Said to changes to told. Okay? So we say something, but we tell somebody. So when there is somebody to whom we are telling something, you have to use told. Okay? I hope you have understood. In our next video, we will see how to change the pronouns, how the pronouns changes from direct speech to indirect speech. Thank you.